guys hyped? You guys hyped? Be hyped. This is Game Pickups Live, coming up with 32 games. Hello and welcome to Gaming Pickups Live! Yes, everybody's live and there in the chat. Yeah, thanks for the follow skills for days. I don't know why we have no alerts, but we don't. It sucks. But yeah, 32 games and a shit ton of accessories and we're doing it live. Doing it live! So, things can go wrong and probably will. And they're usually longer than usual because we don't do quickies on live because, fuck off, this is live. We can talk as much as we want. So, as usual, we get the accessories out of the way first because we picked up a shit ton, a metric shit ton. First up, this bag. The fuck's in it? The fuck's in it? Get out of my way. Get out of my fucking way. I don't feel like shit. Right. First up, Joytech, 4 megabytes, the actual hugeness of this madness. Yes, it's a Joytech 4 megabyte memory card for the Dreamcast. Hell yeah, you guys need this. You need this in your lives, you do, you do. If you don't have a massive, massive hard memory card for your Dreamcast, then fuck it, screw it, we're doing it live. Next up, fuck it, pick this piece of shit up. You remember these things? You might remember these things from Poundland or Pound fucking World or Dollarland or Dollar World. I know. Oh, awesome. Awesome. Got it for 50p. So, it pays to save, guys. It pays to save. Wait a few decades and you might be able to do some awesome. I saved 50% on this piece of crap. It's awesome. It's basically a little handheld Tetris game thing. It's crap. It's crap. It's awesome. It's shite. We love it. Next up, found this in Home Bargains. In fucking Home Bargains. You know, that's shite shop. Look at that. I found this. A PS3 official licensed product. It's a motion game grip. For the freaking, what's it called? The PS3 Wii controller. PlayStation Move, yeah. And how much was it? Like 50p? So it was like 49p. Yeah. Can't go wrong with that. Boom. So I got myself a nice little awesome rubber-handed grip. It's actually got rubber on it. It's even open here, so people have actually touched it. But yeah, it's actually got a rubber handle for that, so that's pretty neat. Next up, got these from Poundland, probably shite headphones, so you can play on my wiki pad and all that with awesome headphones, awesome beans. What else do we get? I finally completed my collection. I did! I finally completed my freaking collection of game console keyrings! I got the PS4! Yes! As you know, as you may know, I've got the PS1, the Atari 2600, PS2, Master System, and Mega Drive. I now have a PS4 to add to the group of keyrings that are the game consoles, so you guys should be freaking jealous of that. If there are any more, they are not by Numskull, I believe, but I will be keeping an eye out for more, so stay tuned for more if I can find them. We went to a completely different cash converters out in the wilderness. So far from here, it was raining there and sunshine here. Crazy, right? So yeah, we went there, never been there before, and we came out with so many goodies. They had a shelf. They had a shelf, guys, of items for just £1. One freaking pound. I got one of these, a freaking gameware bag, for 50p. There you go, 50p. 50p, look at that. I've already got two of these, and it holds a ton of Game Boys and Game Boy games. I've put all of my Game Boy collection in, like, two of these bags, and I picked up a third one because it's overflowing, and I found it today for 50p. Surprisingly, not much, Night Owl. I did not spend much today at all because I keep finding things on the cheap, and I only buy them as cheap. 50p for a freaking Game Boy bag. It's really freaking awesome, and I've got a ton of straps for these, so cannot go wrong. Guys, we're blinging it up. I got a gold PS1 controller for a freaking quid. A gold-plated Wild Things PS1 third-party controller. I ain't even mad. Oh, wow! I didn't even realize the buttons are rubber as well. The buttons are freaking rubber. Apparently, it's got a turbo button as well, which is awesome, so you can set your turbo. if you like that, so you can play a bunch of retro games, such as the Arcade Party Pack, which I definitely recommend on the PlayStation 1. Absolutely fantastic, and it's got the best version of Smash TV you will ever play. And here you go, play it with this, a gold freaking plated controller for PS1. Be jealous. Do it. Next up, we got this. We got a new, what are these called? Freaking HOTUS controllers or whatever they are? Whatever it is, it's a flight control joystick for a quid. Now, granted, it uses the really old, like, gaming port connector, so you can only play this on old computers, or if you can find one of those super rare freaking converters, go pick one of those up. It's by Windstorm, of all things, and responsive buttons. I like that. Doesn't twist, unfortunately, but got myself a nice new flight stick for a PC. Boom. And not only did I do that, I got another one for a pound, and this thing is so freaking heavy. It's a Logitech Warrior flight stick. It's got a twisty knob. No idea what it does. Doesn't press or anything. I have no idea. Oh my god, this thing's so heavy. Wow, it's got some freaking weight to it. This thing, oh my god, it's the pinnacle of class, surely. No idea. Never seen this before in my life, but it's got a ton of buttons, clicky, clicky, clicky goodness. And its connector is, I'll be honest, I don't know. I can't remember. I think that one's serial or whatever it is. I don't know. I forget the names because it's so old. Am I related to Seamus? No, I don't know a single. I'm a flight stick. I am a flight stick. Plus, I've got a HOTUS X. Be fucking jealous, you motherfuckers. I got it for a fiver when Sex screwed up and sold it for a fiver. Ha-ha! So that was awesome. But yeah, got myself a nice... That does not look rude at all. But yeah, really. But yeah, this thing is freaking heavy. No, really. Hold this. How heavy is that? You're like the weakest human I know.
Offense.
I'm not joking either. Grab it.
What's not that heavy?
For a controller. There you go, see, you wimp. Get out of here, scrub. Get out of here. Alright, this isn't gaming related, but also, you guys should be hyped regardless. But anyway, there is a King of the Hill game. King of the Hill Season 1. That boy ain't right. That boy ain't right. If you want to hear how much of that boy ain't right, I picked up the first season of King of the Hill for £2. That boy ain't right. Boom. Yeah, I didn't pick it up a lot of the time simply because a lot of people eBay the prices and put it up fucking all the way up there. The price is off the scales. Too damn high. But this was just £2 in a charity shop. Boom. Look at that. Look at that. King of the Hill. That boy ain't right. It's so sad that she's dead. What's her name? What was her name? Fucking, what was her name? Liana? Luna? Whatever her name. I've got her name. Luan, that's the one. Yeah, she did. Propane and propane accessories. Whoa. Yes, that boy ain't right. See, I picked that up. And I also picked up a couple of other things. This I picked up because this is so shit. I have to watch it. Damn Sea Vampires. I know it's not gaming related, but fuck it. How horrible does that look? Here comes deep shh. Ah, they blanked it off with a freaking wave. This is like the most shittest movie I think I've ever seen in Poundland. I had to pick it up. Poundland sell the shittest, the absolute shittest movies, and they're so cheesy and shit. I've yet to watch one I didn't like because they're that bad. It's like those that bad, it's good. So yeah, if you like some really shit movies, we're gonna see if that one's bad. I also picked up a couple of PSP movies. PSP? PSP, come on. You guys love PSP. They were in Poundland. They were selling Akira 2019 Neo Tokyo is about to explode. Yes, if some anime on USP, UMD, not USD. Come on. For PSP, they're selling PSP movies in Poundland. UMD hype. That is so cool. So if you guys live in the UK, head into your local Poundland or Poundworld. I can't remember which one. It's one of them, not the other one. But yeah. They're still selling PSP games very rarely and PSP movies. Next one, Max Payne. Based on the video game, Max Payne. It's a pretty bad movie, I'll be honest. Of course. I think this one's actually by Uwe Boll, isn't it? No? Did Uwe Boll touch this one? I don't think he did. Ooh, yay. Let's run away from that. Yeah, got shitty Max Payne on PSP. I got a video game movie on a video game console. Yes. And, What else did we get? I think that's all she wrote for them. Well, not everything. Yeah, Pound Town. Yeah, that's right, Shadow. I found the motherload, guys. These were 30 freaking pence each. 30 freaking pence. Let me let that sink into your mind. We got the motherload of figures. Like gaming-related and media-related figures for 30 pence in a charity shop. First up, I can't remember who this is. I think it's Dr. Evil. From freaking, What's his name? Fucking Justin Powers? What's his name? Austin Powers. I forget. I don't watch these things forever. But yeah, I think it's him. I don't know. It looks a lot like him. He's wearing some kind of spacesuit. 30p. Heavy as hell. Next up, I got freaking Kirk for 30p. A figure of freaking Kirk. Oh my god. Cut. We need to start this again. We can't say Kirk. Oh my god. I feel like a fucking Star Wars nerd that's never heard of Star Trek and is trying to come off as a Star Trek freaking fan. Oh my god. The embarrassment. But Picard. Yes. And he's my favourite. It's fucking Picard. I know. God damn it. Yeah, got Picard for 30p. Kirk for 30p. Oh, look at that. I wish it came with the others, but it didn't. But we got freaking Picard and Kirk. Figures exactly the same size. They are going on the shelf of awesomeness, which you guys can see if you really want to. Next up, we picked up Han Solo. Of course, Han Solo, again, 30p. Looks a little bit like him. It's definitely got the clothes right, which is awesome. Next up, the worst of the lot, Anakin Skywalker from episode 2 with a really deformed arm. I think I need to retwist that. There we go. Oh, he's got an action feature. He's a wanker. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, it is confirmed. Anakin Skywalker is a wanker. Oh my God. He has an action feature. Also got Luke Skywalker looking a bit buff there. You want to see the shelf of awesomeness? You will, trust me, if I can find a picture of it. Chewbacca, of course, doesn't look very Chewbacca-y. Looks more like freaking Wolf from, what was it called? Teenage Wolf in London or whatever it's called? Whatever, fucking, that old movie, yeah. Chewbacca, which is awesome. Freaking... This is from something, it snapped off something, but it was 30p, so I picked it up because I don't have a Jabba the Hutt toy, so here we go. And the little pygmy thing that giggles like an idiot in the background. Also picked up Luigi. Apparently he's a car now. He's got wheels on the bottom, and he slides like this. I guess he's sliding into Princess Peach's dress, I don't know, I'm assuming so. And last but not least,
Gary.
It may as well be a Gary celebration because the girlfriend found this one on the shelf. But it was inside the basket for 30p, I swear. Lara Croft, Tomb Raider. She's probably missing her guns. I don't care. I've been looking for a figure of Tomb Raider for so freaking long. And now I finally have one. So let's cheer! Cheer! Yeah! We finally got Lara Croft freaking Tomb Raider. Oh, damn. Damn. 30p. 30p for freaking Lara Croft. Oh, and that's all she wrote in that bag. I'll deal with that bag later. But, I know. 30p in a basket. 30p in a basket. All those freaking awesome figures. 30p. I am so hyped to put those on the shelf, which I will show you guys later, of course. Where am I from? I'm from the UK, Northwest England, otherwise known as the Boonies. The Boonies of England. But yeah, we find some
you
goodies around here.
What, mate?
Fucking what? Yeah. So, Gary, the part you've all been waiting for, video games. Hey, Monster Breath, how you doing, dude? Let's get over to the games. All 32 goodness. Bet you guys are hyped. Let's get this one out of the way. You guys might remember this little movie. Let's see if you guys can make it out. Autofocus, will you work this day? It's trying. I'll give it a second. No, it doesn't want to do it. It did it! It freaking did it! Stormbreaker. Yes, that is right. Stormbreaker. It's a video game based on a movie based on the prequel of a book. and then they turned it into a novel, I think. But it was a really good... What was it called? Point Blank? Point Blank, I think it was called? Great book. Love that. But they made a prequel to it in movie form called Stormbreaker. I found it on Nintendo DS. Stormbreaker.
Rigged.
Alex Rider, Stormbreaker. If you haven't seen Stormbreaker, think of it as 007 James Bond as a teenager, which sounds really horrible, but it's actually not that bad. It's actually an okay movie. I kind of actually wish it brought some sequels, but I guess people were still burnt out from Spy Kids. But yeah, can't go wrong with Stormbreaker. Next up, this piece of shit. Found it for a quid in cash converters. Sale, £1. You'll never guess what it is. It's for the Mega Drive. It is... I think that's International Soccer? International Soccer? FIFA International Soccer? It's a really bad game, but it was £1. It was £1. I don't even think you can get this on eBay for £1. I think it's like £2 on eBay. Yay! Success! Next up, we have Rayman Hoodlum's Revenge on Game Boy Advance. There you go! I freaking love Rayman. If you guys don't love Rayman, you're in the wrong place. And they had a basket of these freaking games, and I really wish I picked them all up. I hope it's still there when we next go next week. Yeah, next week we're going back to that city, town. Is it a city or town?
It's a city.
Is it? Oh, well, no, whatever we go. We're going. Get it. All right. Oh, we'll save that one till a little bit later. Miss Pac-Man on the freaking Mega Drive. Oh, yes. The best version of Pac-Man on the Mega Drive. Boom! Get hyped. Get wrecked. Be jealous. Can't go wrong for a couple of quid. Next up, I actually went up to the cashier and asked if I could have his dick, Tracy.
You did.
I actually went up to her and said, can I have your dick, Tracy?
And I was like, what?
And he went up and got it. How much was Rayman? A couple of quid. I don't know if it's worth anything. It probably isn't. Game Boy Advance games are going incredibly cheap on eBay right now, so now's a good time to be a collector of that. But it was it was £2. So you can't go wrong with that. But yeah, Rayman, freaking awesome. But yeah, I got Dick Tracy for a fiver. I've been trying to get hold of Dick Tracy for a long time, so I figured I'd pick it up for a fiver. I think we can do better elsewhere, but whatever. Now for the fuck... I need to know if I have this game, so bear with me a second.
What's it on?
It's either on Xbox 360 behind you or PS3, so...
What's it called?
It's called Mafia 3. I most assuredly do not have it on PS3. Let's see. No, I don't think we've got it. Boom! We've added Mafia 3. Mafia 2, you dumbass. But yeah, Mafia 2 for £2 on the PS3. Disc only, unfortunately, but for £2, I was getting a game I did not have. So we finally got Mafia 2 on PlayStation 3, which is pretty neat, and for £2, I was not going to say no. Now this one, I've never heard of before, and as a disc only, I was like, go on then, why not? The King of Fighters 12? It's not a franchise I've actually heard of, if I'm honest. It was $3.99, disc only. The King of Fighters 12, I wish I've heard of it, but if there's actually 12 others... I don't know. But yeah, the King of the Fighters. Is it any good, Night Owl? I have no idea. But the King of Fighters 12 for $3.99 disc only. I probably should have checked CEX if the price was worth it, but... it was an impulse buy. It was an impulse buy. No, it's a bad game. Boo! No! It's slow and iffy. Aww. Oh well. Game I didn't have. Picked up a DS game. 42 all-time classics. It was just a cheap one in a charity shop. Nobody wanted it. It was basically, it's got a ton of really shitty games on it, like Checkers, Solitaire, and all that other crap. Does it even list them? No, it's that bad, it doesn't list them. But yeah, it's got a bunch of really shitty games on, so I'm not going to talk about that one too much. Next up, Asphalt Urban GT, again, for a quid. Boom. It's a racing game on your DS, why not? Mostly getting these because the girlfriend's now got a DS, which doesn't play much anymore. Next up, Agatha Christie, The ABC Murders. I love Poirot. Poirot's awesome. And it was $1.99 from a charity shop, so...
I'll play
that. Yeah, she'd play that one because it's a nice little mystery type game. Pretty darn cool. And who doesn't love Poirot? I do. Pretty cool. Oh, by the way, if any of you guys are curious, they all come with manuals. Yep, all come with manuals. So good. I have the Vault-Tec lunchbox. Dude, I have everything Fallout. You name it, I've got it. Well, at least I'm trying to, anyway. Trying to get everything. I've got the collector's edition of all things. I've even still got my Fallout beers up there. I'm saving them until 2077. I'm not even joking. So I better be fucking alive for that. I'm fucking telling myself. Craft Dinner Studios, bitch, please, it's corporate, Dan, now. Selling out my soul. Right, next up, we have PS3 games. Yeah, fuck it, let's do the PS3 games, why not? Yeah, why not? Let's do all the PS3 games, let's get them out of the way. Boom, you guys like PS3, right? Right, next up, Virtua Tennis 4. Could have sworn I got this on the Vita. Do you guys remember when I got a Virtua Tennis game on the Vita? I actually sent that to a friend, Max B, you might see in the chat. Lone Walker, this is Gaming Pickups Live. So I've shown you what we picked up today, which is awesome. Virtua Tennis, not going to talk about that for too long because... Dude, guys, it was fucking 50p, okay? It was 50p, get out of it. Now here's a good one. Murdered, sole suspect. You solve your own freaking murder. Now, if you guys haven't played this, you probably should. Solving your own murder? That is freaking awesome. That is awesome. Even the Smurfy Sam man's, the fiancé man's wants it. So, yeah, murdered, sole suspect, pretty awesome stuff. Cannot go wrong with that one. Fast and Furious Showdown, because the movies are dreadful and the games are probably worse. I love the movies. They're so bad, they're good. So, Fast and Furious Showdown, curious enough, become part of a crew and do some heists, hijacks, and mayhem. So bad. So bad. Yeah, probably okay. Next up, really shitty game. Believe me, I didn't pay $4.99 for it. Generator Rex, Agent of Providence. It was £2 when all said and done, which was nice. Battle with 7 different weapons, explore 10 different environments, and fight alongside Bobbo. Haha. It actually says on the back, fight alongside Bobbo, haha. Haha! Ha, we are so funny. I guess I have to watch Rex to actually fucking know why that's funny. Why is Bobbo funny? I don't fucking get it. Whatever. Next up, I finally own Iron Man 2. Apparently, in my collection of freaking 5,000 freaking games, I never actually got Iron Man freaking 2. What? So, whatever, we got it. Customize your weapons, you know, because War Machine. Suit up as Iron Man or War Machine in a story that takes you beyond the movie, but isn't actually part of the canon, because why would it be? Powerful hand-to-hand combat, fight skyscraper tall enemies. Yay! Excitement. It's probably awful, but whatever. Oh, we've just been given Munch! Even though we have Munch, but it's fine. I will take this. I accept this offering of awesome Galaxy Cookie Crumble. There you go. Gaming Pickups Live. Chocolate Pickups Live. Do it. CX? Goddamn right. Gotta love some CX. CX, yeah, if you don't have this, it's currently £5 in CX. It's also £5 on 360. I kind of regret not getting it on 360, but you guys know, my first... Generation 7? Generation 7? I don't know. But, yeah, it was the first one of that generation was PS3 when it first came out. I didn't even bother with the 360 until 2 years ago?
When I moved in.
Yeah, we didn't get a 360 until, like, 2 years ago, but now I have as many 360 games as PS3, and I love the 360, don't get me wrong, I freaking love it, but I always prioritize the PS3 for some reason, even though the 360 ports are better. I even openly admit that the 360 ports are a fucking 1,000 times better. Yeah, sex is best by Paula. Go to sex. Seriously, best. And also, if you want the tin edition of Killzone 3, now's the time. You guys know I'm a sucker for this shit. I'm trying to get the steelbook editions of every single game I have. Impossible, I know, but I'm still trying to do it. And Killzone 3 is one of them. And it also comes with a nice little plastic cover, which is nice. And the girlfriend found it, of course. Yes, she did. And it was £1.50 for the steelbook edition of Killzone 3, which is cheap as hell. And you cannot go wrong with the steelbooks. Yeah, I'm literally trying to fill up everything. So much so, I have FIFA 14 steelbook edition. It is that bad I picked up FIFA 14 as a steelbook. Because of course I did. Alrighty, what do we have next? Yeah, we got a bunch of PC games if that counts. Hey, K-Bug, thanks for the follow, dude. And welcome. Well, may as well get the Xbox games out of the way. Xbox and 360, I should say. Yeah, just trying to divide these up a little bit, so let's do these. Picked up this one, 007, Agent Under Fire. I have it on GameCube and PlayStation 2. Let's fill out our collection. Let's get it on Xbox as well. Got it for £1 in a nice charity shop. I was a bit of a dick and gave them a £20 note for it, but they had so much change, they were fine with it. Yay! I hate giving £20 notes to any shop. They're the worst. You try. It's like giving a $100 note for a $1 item. It's the worst thing. You're the worst person for doing that. But it's not my fault. The cash machine gave it to me and you can't break it. Because no one wants to. No one wants to. And the cash machine. Yeah, well, I don't want to. Why would I talk about freaking cash machine? Yeah, the cash machine took for ages. There you go. You guys know now. No, really, we were stood there for about 5 minutes. I'm not joking. I was like, I always draw this amount of money and stood there for a good 5 minutes while it was like, please wait. You motherfucker. But anyway, yes, Agent Under Fire for Xbox. Next. What is this? Oh, Resident Evil 6 Steelbook Edition for 360. I told you, I'm a freaking sucker for this shit. I've got Resident Evil 6. Not on 360, I don't believe. So we finally have that. But yeah. We've got the Steelbook Edition. Oh yeah, it's got an advertising for DMC out in 2013. Yay, better go pick it up, guys. But yeah, it comes with a manual and that. It was £1.49 in cash converters. Boom, cannot go wrong. Steelbook Edition of Resident Evil 6. Why not? Why not? Let's do it. Hey. I've got Resident Evil 6. Well, I've already got it on 360, but guess what? Got the Steelbook Edition. Does not matter. I will always pick up the Steelbook Edition. Always, if it's a really great price, like £1.49. Come on. FIFA is for case cannibalizing, not collecting. That is true. That is why I've cannibalized every other version. Even FIFA 14, I cannibalized it and replaced it with the Steelbook Edition. Can't cannibalize the Steelbook, though. That's impossible. But yeah, Hitman Blood Money, the best Hitman game. If you haven't played a Hitman game yet, play Hitman Blood Money and wait till you get to the awesome level where you can dress up as a donut guy and deliver donuts. I love that mission. That fucking mission was brilliant. There are so many different ways you could do it. You can also go into one of the rooms and because the woman invites you in because you're big, buff, and hot, and she wants to fuck you. Yeah, the guy's wife invites you into her fucking bedroom to fuck.
The guy's wife?
Yeah, the guy you're meant to kill. His wife wants to bone you. Which is awesome. Of course she doesn't, because she's got something important you need to take off her. Spoilers. But hey, Hitman Blood Money, pick it up. I got it on Xbox, because it's fucking Blood Money. Next up, promotional disc, not for resale. That was the whole reason I picked this up, guys. For 50 freaking P. 50p. It's a disc only, but it came in a case, which is nice. It is for Xbox 360. It's a promotional disc and not for resale, which is nice. I like picking these things up. UFC Undisputed 3. I say this every time I read this fucking title. Why is it undisputed? I'm sorry, but if it's undisputed, no one's fighting because there's no dispute. The name boggles my freaking mind. It should be called Disputed because you're fighting over the title. Why is it called Undisputed? It makes no sense. It makes no sense. You're using a word and it doesn't even mean what it means. Oh, I will rant about that forever. Crystal Tips, thank you for the follow. That's a quite a user-friendly name. I like that. Quite easy to read. And MC Funky, I missed you earlier. Thank you for the follow. Welcome. UFC Ultimate freaking crap. Yep, it is. It is crap. But I got it. It was a promotional only disc. I had to pick it up for 50p. Why not? And the last 360 game we picked up, the first and best of the Fear franchise. First Encounter Assault Recon Fear. Now this is fucking nice. They get horror. Not horror. They get spoopy. They get spoopy right. The way, what is her name? Alma? I think her name's Alma. But the way they portray her in the game, every time you see her, gives you freaking goosebumps on the back of your neck. Your hair spikes up every time you see static on the screen of your radio getting static. It is so freaking good. And not only that, it's a great first-person shooter as well. Fuck! I know. Fear. Can't go wrong with it. Best. Next! Undisputed Ultimate Contest. I'll get it. It's still dumb. Ulmer is a bitch, though. She is a bitch, but she tries to fuck you, so it's okay. I don't get why that's a bad thing. It gets further in the game, and she wants to fuck you. She wants to have the ultimate baby with you.
Yeah, but she's a ghost thingy.
Yeah, it's weird. She wants to bone you. What's the problem? What's the problem? Why won't she be able to? She's not a ghost. She's an actual person with horrible psychic powers and wants to kill everybody.
Fatality.
Oh well, it's fine. She does kill you though, if you touch her. So I don't know how the sex thing's gonna work. Alright, next up. I picked up Zoo Cube. I don't fucking know what this is. I don't know, but I figured for a few quid I was gonna pick it up. Why not? It's puzzled. I don't know. It's some kind of a puzzle game. Put your puzzle solving skills to work. Simple to learn, tricky to master. Zoo Cube offers addictive, engaging, heart racing 3D puzzle action. I don't fucking know.
Sweetener.
It makes no fucking sense. Really makes no sense. Oh, by the way, 2 seconds, guys. I don't know, it's just bothering me. I'll turn it on later. All right, next. Oh, that reminds me as well. La, 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 la. There we go. All right, so, where were we? Where were we? I don't actually know. I don't know. I got sidetracked there for a second. Oh, hold on, I need to find the Windows button. Where are you? There we go. I just realized I didn't have the Twitch chat up. My deepest apologies. All right, so... what else did we get? Well, we got Super Fruit Fall. Not for £3. No, that is crossed out. It doesn't actually say how much it is. Oh, fair enough then. But yeah, Super Fruit Fall. It's a fun enough game on the Wii. I don't know what to say about it really. It's just an okay puzzle game. Dunno, we'll talk about that later. Let's leave PlayStation 2 till last simply because I'm fucking prejudiced. Fuck PlayStation 2. We'll leave it till last. Fuck it. I picked this up. White Label published double pack Monkey Island 1 and 2. Aww, yeah. It was £1 in a charity shop. Nice big box. Fun stuff. Monkey Island 1 and 2. That is a nice pickup. Sure, it's white label. It's not the original. But you never find big box PC games anymore. You never find them. So, you know what? That's fine. I can work with this. Why not? All right. So, for £1, I found a game by LucasArts. Boom. Grim Fandango. Aw, yeah. Yep, goddamn right, I found Grim Fandango with this. Oh, so good. It's a re-release, of course. It's not the original release, but it's a great classic. It is released on GOG. There is a remastered edition. Definitely pick up the remastered edition. Don't buy this unless you're like me and you can run it on fucking older systems, and you can do that. But yeah, definitely worth picking up. It's a great fucking game. Great humor. It's an okay... puzzle? What's it called? What is it? Fucking Walker? Oh, what do you call them? No. Ah, I forgot what you fucking call them. But it's nice. You got horribly stuck. Walkthroughs. Walkthroughs out the ears. That's what we did. Except we had to read books back in the day. I remember going into fucking game and going, dude, got Grim Fandango strategy guide, please. No, we don't do that. Fuck! So it's fine. Don't you worry about it. All right, next up. The limited edition of Caesar 4. For so long have I desired this game, and for 99p I freaking got it. Caesar 4, nice lovely cardboard case, which is nice for 99p. Behold the glory. Now, Caesar 3 is one of my favorite games of all time. It is a great strategy game made by the same people that made Pharaoh and, what was the other one? Fucking Mount Olympus or whatever it was called? Great freaking game. Great freaking game. Caesar 4 is a sequel to Caesar 3 in a 3D type engine. It's a completely different animal to Caesar 3. I understood that, and a lot of people don't really like it. I will find out myself personally, but I really would like to see how this came out, so I will definitely be playing this at some point, which is nice. Caesar 4, fun game, boom. Zeus, Mount Olympus, whatever it was called. I don't know. Ship Simulator 2008. It was in a charity shop for 99p. This is one of the few times I found a freaking simulator game in a charity shop. It was 99p, Ship Simulator. I want to set up my wheel and bloody float a ship, man. 2008. That means this was released in 2007. Holy shit, this game's 10 years old. You know, is it bad that mentally I think 2008 was not that long ago? Do you still think that? Do you think 2008 wasn't that long ago? It was like a few years back.
Sometimes.
I still think 2008's recent. I still think it's fucking recent, and yet it was 10 fucking years ago. Well, it's fine. Act of War for 99p. Yo, Lone Walker, fix your fucking speakers. Turn them down, you fucker. I love you. When people bitch about the audio of a stream, turn it down. You make no fucking sense. But yeah, Act of War, direct action. Now, this is a great fucking strategy game. If you like real-time strategy, Act of War is that. I've got... I swear they came out with a couple of games, and I swear I have them on either GOG or Steam. I've got them somewhere. I've got them fucking somewhere. I don't know where they are. Hey, Red, how you doing? Oh, God. I can't read your name. Reader Defeater. Reader Defeater. There you go, I read it. There was just so many different words in there. Reader Defeater. I just read it as Red Erdath. Feta. Dumbass. But yeah, Act of War. Can't go wrong with that. Boom. I picked that up for a couple of quid. Prince of Persia Trilogy. For a couple of quid. Comes with all three Prince of Persia games on PC. Holy shit. And apparently, it has controller support. Apparently. According to this, it has Windows compatible gamepad on its back, which means it probably works with a 360 controller, probably. So I'm willing to give this thing a chance, because playing these games at 60 FPS on PC. But yeah, welcome. Oh, it's your first time on Beam? Welcome. Hold puppet down. Got it. There you go. All right. So, what do we got? I suppose we better jump through these, I guess. Let's show you the first and shitty one of the PlayStation 2 lineup. Garfield 2. Right, next. You've just fucking reminded me. Axe George, you fucking reminded me. You mentioned keyboard. I bought a keyboard today. It's upside down, isn't it? It's upside down. I bought a retro keyboard from Packard Bell. This thing weighs a freaking ton. It's so good. It's so freaking good. And it was a couple of quid as well. Did anyone used to play Frets on Fire? Remember? Does anyone remember Frets on Fire? Is that thing still around? That is so freaking cool. But yeah, I used to actually play Frets on Fire like this. What was that? It was like the strum button. No, it was I binded it to like them three keys. And I used spacebar and strum. I used to pick up, yeah, a keyboard like that for years. I know. Frets on Fire. God, that was so fucking awesome. But yeah, pick this up for a couple of quid. Proper, super heavy. Like, it's not full mechanical, I don't think. I think it's like one really old, like, type hybrid. I don't know. I don't care. But yeah, really fucking sexy. Awesome. Awesome keyboard. So yeah, thanks for reminding me, Axe George. 100% while I mentioned it. Yep. Exactly. See, we're in sync. We're in sync, and I like that. You're only here for my sexy beard? It will be longer one day. I'll work on that. Tenchu, Fatal Shadows. For just a pound. Tenchu, if you guys like your, like, assassination-type stealth-type games, Tenchu's a very good series to play. Published by Sega, of course. Slay multiple enemies simultaneous with new stealth moves. Ooh, fighters, deadly ninjas. New camouflage moves and one times other special moves. Okay. That makes no sense. But yeah, one kills for honor, one kills for revenge. Tenchu, Fatal Shadows, definitely pick it up. And probably the best video game to ever come out from the UK, ever. Robot Wars. Arenas of Destruction. How many copies of this game do I need? All of them. Seriously, I'm gonna make a freaking... I'll just make a whole collage of Robot Wars games on the wall.
and it'll make me happy. So yes, boom, Robot Wars, Arenas of Destruction. It's so bad it's good. It's buggy as hell. It's so bad. No game beats San Andreas on PS2. Nope, San Andreas is the best game on PlayStation 2. But there are still very good games on PlayStation 2. Such as Shadows of War. Shadows of Rome. Shadow of Rome. That's a great game. Awful game. Great game. It's really bad, and yet it's really good. The really bad parts, the stealth parts with Octavianus, and no one likes them. The great parts is when you're with Agrippa, and you're chopping people in half in the arena. Oh my god. God! Oh, so good. But yeah, that's all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. Holy shit! That was like the longest Game and Pickups video I've ever done. It's not. I think the longest Game and Pickups video I ever did was like 2 hours long. But yeah, we got through it all. We did it. Cut! 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 Cut the cake! Cut the video. We're done. Good work, ladies and gentlemen. We can all go home now. Let's do this. I'll see you guys next time. Take care. All that good stuff. That's it. Done. Cut. Done. Bye. Shadows of Zombies is a